Hello. As first part of the session, I would like to give you some insights into my own perspective on data standards and also the motivation coming from different applications that should be done on this. This work is done together with the EFAS Working Group Standardized Data Formats for Big Data and Audiology, as well as colleagues from Paris and Oldenburg especially. Yeah, many audiological data are collected worldwide. And in this talk, I will focus a bit on the topic of audiological tests. So you see some examples displayed here in this list. Different tests may be conducted in different databases or in different institutes. The same test can be measured in different conditions. Different labels can be contained, such as diagnostic decisions or treatment recommendations for hearing devices, for example. Then we can measure them in different setups, for example, in free field or in headphone conditions, and different populations may be contained in one database. Despite these differences, I would assume that knowledge and experience is stored in these databases, which would be very valuable to exploit, for example, for learning about existing patient groups in terms of characterizing our hearing impaired population worldwide, and also extracting knowledge which is suitable for audiological decision support. But regarding the data formats, we have some questions that are open. For example, how to perform analysis on combined databases if they are stored in different formats, or how to make sure that databases exhibit the same content. And as a combination, this means we need to ask ourselves how to make sure that databases are interoperable. Yeah, and the solution for that is data standardization. And here I would like to present you the Open EHR approach, which is an open standard for the development of electronic health records. In this approach, interoperability is obtained by separating information and knowledge. You will see later how this works exactly. And this standard was already established for medical fields by Antje Wolf and colleagues, for example, in pediatric intensive care and microbiology reports. The whole approach is community-driven. That means participants can define standards, but they are reviewed by the community and can be improved based on that. And open tools are available for modeling these data standards. And if you want to know more details on that, you can also have a look at the talk recorded by Antje Wolf, which I linked here. In this talk, I would like to explain the methods of Open EHR along with our example of auditory profiling, which is a method by Sack et al. 2022. And this method aims to characterize distinct groups in the database by so-called profiles. And these profiles exhibit differences in different dimensions of audiological tests, here, for example, audiogram, speech test, and loudness scaling. And as we would typically do as a database description, we would just write it as it is written here. So we would give for the audiogram the measured frequencies, then we say which speech test we did, and maybe we did a binaural SRT. We perform some loudness scaling at narrowband noises at 1 and 4 kHz. However, if we want to do this with another database and compare the results, for example, how can we make sure that databases are interoperable? This means that we basically need to answer the question, how can this database be described by a data standard? And in the terms of Open EHR, this is then the concept of archetypes, which are the building blocks describing clinical concepts. For example, in our case, these are audiological tests. And an archetype contains all information that we need to describe this test, including every property that we may need in any use case. So it provides complete metadata and documentation, and it also is, in terms of Open EHR, a maximum data set with minimal constraints, which means we don't limit properties here at this stage in this data standardization. And for the current example, we need archetypes for audiogram, speech test, and loudness scaling. Here you can see how this is displayed in the so-called archetype designer, an online tool to model that. In this representation, you have a mind map for every archetype, and here you basically have the two categories of data, so all data that are collected or needed during this measurement, and protocol defines all the properties that describe how the test was conducted. As a second step towards describing the database by this data standard, we need to define a template, and this finally describes our database by providing a composition of archetypes, and in this template, archetypes are constrained, which means we only include properties that are necessary for our specific use case, here auditory profiling. And this means for the audiogram, for example, we indicate which frequencies were measured, and for the category presentation mode, we give air conduction, for example. While for the speech test, we have here some more examples, so we need to indicate the test name, the test procedure, the tested site, and this is all collected systematically. As you can see here in a different representation. So here we see a test entry form for our template, and here we can just enter some data to check if our defined template with the archetypes in the background is working well. So far, we have talked about archetypes and template, and now the third and last step is to define so-called extract, transform, and load processes. And this is needed to transform our data source in this original format to a new standardized data set, which is not losing any information, but it is in the standardized and desired format. And as examples here that are relevant for us, we have a joint French-German project where we want to share the data, and then if we define for this in the standardized format, this can directly be exchanged. And it can also provide a suitable data structure for the auditory profiling approach. Yeah. And this process from data source to a standardized data set, we can do for every database that we want to compare. For example, in this case, if we want to apply this auditory profiling on it, you do this for both databases, arrive at two standardized data sets, but they may exhibit different items of the archetypes, but they are relying on the same archetypes. So this shows the flexibility again of this shown approach. And given these existing items and their properties, we can perform an interoperability check and see if it's useful to include these two databases in the same tool. And we also have an additional approach available for merging of auditory profiles. So the potential here would be if we have many data sets in the same format that we could easily merge different databases and easily estimate profiles based on a large number of patients. To sum up, I presented you our application example of auditory profiling to present you the methods of OpenEHR. And this OpenEHR approach allows for the description of different databases by the same set of archetypes but different templates. And therefore we can obtain an interoperability check of different databases. The approach is flexible for other use cases, so we can apply any method or tool that one would have and want to apply on different databases, and this is possible because of the modular structure of the approach, because we can separate information and knowledge in terms of archetypes and templates, and open tools are available to model archetypes and templates. The whole approach is a community effort. As I mentioned before, we need reviewers, and everyone can participate, everyone can define archetypes, and this was started as an EFAS working group last year. And finally, I'm now interested about the potential that could be leveraged if data standards were established worldwide. And yeah, for this purpose, we will now hear about the community perspective by means of our survey results. And then I'm very curious to see what our experts in our panel discussion have to say about this topic. Thank you for your attention.